God bless you, everybody, from the Los Angeles Church. Mesimo servitori la congregaco. Mangapte na isule de vleske ke diken kako DVD right now. Ame huji sile my manglam katarodel tavel kako DVD and de saboren gevas. That this DVD would bless your life. What you're about to watch will transform the way you think, and you would make the greatest decisions of your entire life to accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. We're going to show you regarding the Bema judgment and the great white throne judgment, how people that receive Jesus will be at the Bema judgment, and people that reject Jesus will be at the great white throne judgment. I plead with you, open your hearts, open your minds, and let God speak to you. Hear what the Holy Spirit is about to say. I pray that you would be blessed through this movie, in Jesus' name. Enjoy the movie.
Mordad, Mordel, Lord, I pray right now, as you send me to these people, Mordad, witnessing, Lord, I pray, Mordad, Mordel, that you would shine your light through me. I pray that you would be there every step of the way, Lord. I pray that every word would be from you, Lord, and not from me. As I witness to these people, be there every step of the way. Speak to them. Minister to them. Use me, Mordad. Here I am as your servant, Lord. Have your way. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray. Amen.
My son, I have heard your prayer, and I will go before you in this house. Fear not. All you need to do is be obedient to my spirit. I will give you the words to speak unto these people, words of my love, of my forgiveness. So fear not.
Dicta Consul.
Hello.
Hi, God bless you. I'm a servant of the Los Angeles Church, and I wanted to come pray with you, invite you to church. If you give me the chance, hopefully share a few scriptures with you.
Che Consul Kawudan.
Thank you. Happy God that you came. I've been praying for somebody.
We've been trying
to
reach out to the people.
God bless you, Prala. I've been praying so hard for you to come.
God bless
to share
you for
opening
your door and inviting us in.
No, I'm so happy you came. Chachis.
Wally, Lisa, God bless you guys for opening your house and allowing me to come in and just have a little time in fellowship. God's been doing some amazing things in my life, and I would like to share a little bit what God's been doing in the church. He's been doing amazing things here in the city of Los Angeles, and it's something that it's hard to explain. The presence of God that's been there, the word that the pastor's been given, the anointing upon the church, and it's something that you're missing out on. You're not too far from the church, and we would like to see you guys there.
What? Who let him in? Did you leave him in here? He needs to get out of here. This is my house.
But hey, Dick, I'm going to tell you something right up front, because that's the kind of person I am. I didn't even want you in my house. I heard about all this Christianity. You know what? On Sundays, we cook ourselves a little dinner. We enjoy ourselves. I don't want to hear about Christianity. I'm fine. My family's fine. I didn't even want you here. So pare another point of Romania to do Vika to a little woman. So Janine Goma now deal. What did they really know? Each churches. So I don't like Christians coming to my house, and the other ones who came, I told them to leave.
Wally, it just things like I told you that's been going on in the church, and God's been giving us servants the opportunity to share the word. And there's just a few things that I just wanted to explain to you that God has put it upon my heart to share with you, Lisa Wally. God sent his son on this earth because he loved you and me so much. And why did he have to send his son? Was to save us from the wrath of God. And by Jesus dying and resurrecting on that cross, he redeemed us. He purchased us. And because he purchased and redeemed us, he saves us from the judgment. And now that we're covered by the blood of Jesus, we are able to go to the Bema Seat judgment. And these are the things that God been ministering to us in our lives. So this is just something that I pray that the Holy Spirit would minister to you, Lisa, and that you would receive this word in your heart, Wally, that God would allow it to move in your guys' lives. I pray that you receive this.
Don't listen to him. He's lying to you. Your life is fine the way it is. There's no such thing as a judgment. You only live once. Jesus isn't going to make you happy. The pills you take every night is what makes you happy.
Bledik, may karap sa kundi magdada, magpapurya. Bledik, amay chordya mo kafrin. That's why you're tila ming mo del janil. Sukras, kaya kangari so peres tu sa kuhay mo sa mga. Tu mga sa tiyabe sa just tiyabe sa mga lovey di chogares sa men. Di na may demo kogumi business. I know what the church is all about and I don't want to hear it.
I'm opening your heart to what I have to say. This is my servant that I sent to your house to bring you salvation, to bring you eternal life. Listen to everything that my servant has to say, because he's not speaking his own words. He's speaking my words.
Wally, Lisa, let me share this scripture with you guys. God bless you. 1 minute. Romans 10, 9. If you declare with your mouth Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. Now this scripture right here, we call it the sinner's prayer. This is how we accept Jesus. We confess it with our mouth and we believe in our heart that Jesus came on this earth, died for your and my sins, and resurrected on the third day. And if you truly believe and confess this in your heart that God raised Jesus from the dead, you will be saved. And once you are saved, Jesus promises eternal life. You will be saved from judgment, and you will receive a crown in heaven that eventually you would cast at Jesus' feet. And that is the glory of being saved, to give Jesus worship, honor, and praise. And I'm asking you now, would you want to accept Jesus in your hearts, in your lives?
Yes, yes. That's what I want. Yes, I want
so,
this.
Tigaya. We didn't do nothing.
No.
We don't need this.
No.
I'm tired of hearing about the churches. I'm tired of hearing about the churches. I'm like Christians.
Okay, Akana, make
you do what you want.
Okay.
Lisa, do you want to accept Jesus Christ?
Yes, yes, I want to accept Jesus.
Do you believe that Jesus died for you and resurrected on the third day?
Yes, I do.
Shayna!
Close your eyes and repeat after me. Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
Thank you
thank
for coming you. Onto this earth.
Thank you for coming onto this earth.
And dying. And being beat up. And taking all my sins upon you. Thank you, Lord, for washing me your precious blood. I believe and I confess today. That Jesus died.
And resurrected.
On the third day. For my sins. And I believe. That one day,
I will be with Jesus in paradise.
Today, Lord.
Take over my life.
I believe not only that I confess with my mouth. But with all my heart. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Because of what you said today and what you believe with your heart, today your name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life. And because of this confession, you will be one day at the Bema Seat Judgment, where Jesus will place a beautiful crown on your head, and eventually you would cast it back at his feet, how much you care and you love for him. And you will be with Jesus forever and ever and ever, eternity in heaven. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Glory to God, Wally. Your wife just accepted Jesus. I pray that you would also accept Jesus today. Don't reject Jesus, Wally. Jesus is trying to reach out to you right now. Please receive him in your heart, Wally.
Bledik, I mean, I told you earlier, I didn't want this. Janasa made a difference. Chimu daljama me karikas. Di daljama ho humi akala. do me a favor. Get out of my house. Now, get out. Wow. I'm tired of Christians. I'm tired of hearing about the church and about Jesus and that we're all wrong. Deke, get out. Wow. No. You said what you had to say.
Today
get
is
out
the
now.
Day of salvation.
No, not talking about
tomorrow
salvation.
Is not
Deke, we're fine. My family's fine.
Wow.
No.
Don't reject
do me
the
favor.
Word
I told you before. Get out.
Do not reject
no.
Jesus.
Get out now.
Please, Wally.
No, I can't leave. You just want to go away. You want to
see
what you want to do. They don't love it. I can't leave. Get out. Now.
God bless you, Wally.
I don't know what was with this man tonight. I pray that if it's sinking his heart, I don't know why did this man throw me out. I don't know what I couldn't get to him. What did I do wrong?
You're pathetic. You call yourself a preacher? You couldn't even talk right in there. Did you really think that you could come here and save his life? I got news for you, buddy. He belongs to me.
Lord, I pray that you use me tonight for your will, for your glory. I pray that those people, that man, that woman, that your word would sink in their heart, Lord, and that they will not reject you. I pray that this man would understand, Lord, that I'm a servant of yours, and that he should not throw me out, Lord, and that he would accept the word that was given him tonight. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray.
Plead for my servant.
Push off. Not done. She should be too undercover. Man should be undercover. They do not reject you tonight. They rejected me. You were obedient to me tonight. You done my will.
Cia de love. Sa trovo, sa chino. You know what? These pills, this is what I need.
Come on, just one? That's not gonna take any of your pain away. You need more than one. You're a big boy, Wally. You need a lot more than that to cover up your sorrows. You're not really gonna die if you take them all. Give it a try. Take all of them. There you go.
I want to make this clear. It's not the pills that was the problem. It was him depending on the pills. He had an opportunity to accept Jesus, but instead, he rejected him. Is this heaven? I've been in hell. Is this your kingdom, Jesus? Am I gonna be accepted in? I bow my knee before you, Lord.
Wally, it's time for you to give an account for your life on earth.
Angel, is Wally's name written in the Lamb's Book of Life?
Wally, you must go into eternal punishment. for you rejected
no,
my salvation.
No, no.
You rejected my grace, my mercy.
Sorry.
Angels, take him into eternal punishment.
I want to go to the kingdom.
Such a great job. You listened to every thought I planted in your head. You thought you were fine in your religion, in your old ways, in your tradition. You thought you were fine as a closet drug addict. And when the opportunity came for you to accept the gospel, you rejected. Because you reject it, you'll burn in the lake of fire for eternity. Great job, Wally. I'm so proud of you.
You lied to me. You're a liar, just like they said you were. You're a deceiver. You're an accuser.
I'm going to the lake of fire today because I rejected the Son of God. I rejected his voice. I rejected his spirit. I rejected believing that the cross would give me life. I thought that Catalunya was my title. And I thought that to my home I had a one-way ticket. But I realized all the things I heard about Christianity were true. That he gave you a mansion in heaven. And that he written down your name in the Lamb's Book of Life. And when I didn't see you in there today, and they said my name was not there, I knew that I was damned forever. And as long as you got breath, don't make the same mistake I made. Jesus is the way. Jesus is the life. There's no other truth but him. And in this world, it's not it. It's not finished when you die. There's another world. There's either the beautiful kingdom of Jesus or the fiery hell. I pray today you don't make the same mistake I made.
Angels. Cast them into the lake of fire.
No! No!
Church, today I prayed and I asked God for direction that Jesus himself would touch me and use me tonight. Tonight, I'm going to give you about two choices that we make. Either you make a choice to live for Jesus, to run the race, aitaresas, kaubima, judgment, where we receive a crown, a reward.
Amen.
And this is done when you choose God. Or you could reject Jesus, completely rejecting Jesus. And if you die without Jesus, you'll end up at the great white throne judgment. Either you're at the Bema judgment or at the great white throne. Today God is laying before you life and blessings or death and curses. God says choose life. Asunan Church. In order to receive Jesus, today is the day of salvation.
Amen.
And all you need to do is accept them in your heart. It's not complicated. You just need to say, Lord, come into my heart.
Hallelujah.
Spirit, lead me where my trust is without borders. Let me walk upon.
Boring.
Are you gonna listen to this guy? I think your wife's becoming a holy roller. You know, it's time to get out of here. There's a lot to do. This is a waste of time. See what your friends are doing. Why don't you pull out your phone? See what's going on with the boys. I'm telling you, just get her an Uber and let's get out of here. Let her go home. You've been thinking about divorcing her anyway. Just make a problem, make an argument, send her home on an Uber, and let's go.
I've been preaching and telling you about the Bema judgment, the great white throne judgment. Now, after everything what I said, who here wants to receive Jesus for the first time in your life as Lord and Savior? And what about Penel, that today is the day of salvation? Don't wait for tomorrow. Tomorrow is promised to no man. Today, accept Jesus. You don't know what's going to happen once you leave these doors. Accept Jesus right now. I plead. I plead. I ask you, please. Mureplal, murepeya. Accept Jesus. What are you waiting for? I pray now and I ask you again. Who wants to accept Jesus?
I want to accept Jesus.
So you wanted to accept Jesus, Justine. Praise God. Sarbushos.
Ashley,
I'm so happy that you're receiving Jesus today. Ashley, Asun, this is the greatest decision of your entire life. This is the best thing that could ever happen to you.
Okay.
I want you to know that what you're going to do now, your name is going to be written in the Lamb's Book of Life. You are going to have real estate in heaven. Jesus is going to put a crown on your head. And this is what you're going to do. But doing this, this is going to take you into a relationship with God. Are you ready to take the sinner's prayer?
Yes, I'm ready.
Amen. Close your eyes and repeat these words. But let these words come from your heart. Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
I receive you today.
I receive you today.
As my Lord and Savior.
As my Lord and Savior.
I believe. That you died.
And resurrected.
On the third day.
Cleanse me. Forgive me.
And save me. I receive you, Lord.
In the name of the Father.
The Son.
And the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Ashley, God bless you.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. It fills me with joy when I hear and I see people receiving God. I am so filled. I feel like Jesus is touching me right now. I'm so happy. And I thank God for what's happening today in the church. But I feel in my heart that God is speaking to one more person. There's somebody here that God wants to touch, but Satan is all over you. You're listening to Satan and not Jesus. Listen, Caudel, God wants to save your soul. Accept Jesus today. I want to give you an opportunity. There's still one more person in this church that you need to accept Jesus. You have an opportunity. Is there anyone else that wants to receive Jesus?
Don't listen to him. All these Christians, they're hypocrites. You're better off than them. Christianity is not for you. It's for losers. They're all broke. You're important. You have better things to do. You have places to go and people to see. Let's get out of here.
Why are we leaving before church ended? Why are you doing this?
I actually got addicted by United Christian. And so just accepted God. Hey, the boys are waiting for us.
What boys? Where are you going?
The boys. Drop you off home.
Drop you off home and the boys are waiting for me.
But hey, where are you going? We didn't even stay and let church end.
Hey, don't worry about it.
No, I am worried about it. Why are we running out of church?
Hey, the boys are
waiting for me, and like now you're Christian all of a sudden.
The boys ain't that serious.
What do you mean they're not that serious? Just get in the car.
Devla, forgive my husband, Devla Jesus. Forgive him for what he did, Father God. Devla, I want more of you in my life, Jesus. Please, Devla, help us, Father God, to come closer to you, Jesus. Help my husband, Father God. Why are you in a hurry? Stop driving like that. We're gonna get killed. Stop it. Drive right.
Why, Priscilla, you wanted to bring me to church today? Priscilla, you forced me to church. I'm dropping you off home and the boys are meeting me. I'm meeting the boys at the bar. I'm gonna drop you off home. Alright? Because you're a holy roller. Now you're a Christian. Like, you want people to look at you. Is that what it is? But you're a Christian? You wanna be somebody? Man, you're stupid. Man, Chachis, you're stupid. You're stupid. But you think that's true, all that's true, but all they want, they just want you to come to church and dine on. They want money. You know how it is. But now you're Christian all of a sudden. Like, you was praying. Since when? You never prayed before one day in your life, but now you're praying.
Can't we just go eat? Forget the boys. I'm hungry. Let's go eat something.
Where do you want to go? I'll take you home. You can eat.
I don't want to go
home. But hey, I'm going to take you home. And I'm gonna go. The boys are waiting for me. They've been waiting for 1 hour.
Hey, let's just go do something together.
Hey, don't stop. But what do you want?
Why are you acting like this?
I've been with you all day. I took you to church. Now, Tira John. But you wanna go eat now?
Ara!
Again, he had time after time opportunity to accept Jesus, but instead of accepting Jesus, he completely rejected him. But Ashley accepted Jesus Christ. Hallelujah! Ashley is bringing gold, silver, and precious stones, them is barimos, for receiving Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Into the fire only to take out a crown to put on him.
I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go to prepare a place for you, I will come back and receive you unto myself. For where I am, there you will also be. In my Father's house are many rooms and many mansions. And that's why I go to prepare a place for you. And the only way is through my sacrifice, my blood, my body, my mercy and grace. There's no other way up to heaven. Earth will pass away, but my kingdom will last forever. Amen. God's benefit to my living. For what I have for you is eternal. What I have for you, this world can't offer you. What I have for you is eternal life. This world will pass away. Everything in this world will pass away. But my kingdom will last forever. Hallelujah.
Praise of Jesus. She accepted the calling. She accepted. God touched her heart. She didn't care what everybody said. She didn't was
Nazla Janin.
She mangla nothing more but Jesus Christ. What's holding you back? Lajav ginosto ke kumpanya kampanel.
Oh, he became a Christian. Now we could step on him and we could do anything we want. Now he's a little koblo, homobo.
Christians are weak. I'm sorry, they're not. They're smart because they make the best thing, the best decision ever in their life. Hallelujah. Brother John, oh John, I wish I could say the same for him. John rejected Jesus.
του μάγκας μάντα δέει αγνάτσο τρόνο αβά
Lord, Deva, I want to do for you, Deva, more, Father God. Deva, strengthen me, Father God. Deva, you gave me your son, Father God, that paid, Deva, the ultimate price, Father God. Deva, I want to store, Father God, my treasures, Deva, here on earth, Father God. I want to live for you, Father God. Deva, I want to do all I can for you, Deva, while I'm here, Father God. For your glory, Father God. In Jesus' name.
Dear Matthew, God worship you and bless you.
Amen. All glory goes to God. 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verses 10. By the grace of God has given me, I laid a foundation as the expert builder, and someone else is building on it, but each one should be careful how he builds. For no one can lay any foundation other than the one that is already laid, which is Jesus Christ. If any man builds on this foundation using gold, silver, costly stones, wood, hay, or straw, his work will be shown for what it is, because the day will bring to the light. It will be revealed with fire, and the fire will be tested of the quality. For each man's work, if what it is built survives, he will receive his reward. If it is burnt up, he will suffer loss. He himself will be saved, but only as one escapes through the flames.
Matthew, what does that scripture mean?
What it means is us Christians, we are going to be at the Bema judgment. And the Bema judgment is all the works that we did for Christ here on earth that we receiving all our rewards in heaven. Hello.
Hey, Matthew.
Good, Pastor. How are you?
Good. I just wanted to see how you guys are doing. How's your wife? How's the family?
Amen. Everybody's good. Family's good. Thank you, Jesus. We just had a great time in worship. Was reading the word, and we thank God we're encouraged.
Praise the Lord. You know, Matthew, you've been in church for a while now, and I never really see you involved. We're going to get together in a few days, like 2-3 days from now, and we're trying to gather up food and money so we can feed the homeless. You know, there's a lot of people on the streets. We want to help these people. You know, the Bible teaches us, Matthew, that if we feed the homeless, if we help the people that don't have money, that those that have food, that it's just like doing it unto Jesus.
Yeah.
So I wanted to know, Matthew, if you wanted to go and join us.
Well, Pastor, I would love to come, but unfortunately, I have to take the family to the mall, so I'm going to just take them to the mall, so I'm not going to be able to make it.
Wow, okay. All right, Matthew. Well, God bless you, man. I guess I'll see you Sunday church.
Okay, Pastor. I'll see you then. God bless.
God bless.
Bye.
Hey, man. You got any spare change? I'm kind of hungry.
Caraca, Matthew, do you look like
Joe? Sir, what are you going to do with the money? You're just going to go and you're going to buy drugs with it? Is that what you're going to do? You ain't going to go buy food. You're going to go buy drugs or alcohol.
disciples. God bless you.
How are you?
Good, good. How you doing? God bless you, Matthew.
Hey, Pastor. How are you?
Good, babe. Good. God bless you.
Good to see you.
How you been?
Good, good.
Praise God. Praise God. Thank you. God bless you. Matthew, I came today. I wanted to come and see how you're doing. You know, I only see you Sundays.
Yeah.
I only see you Sundays, and it's great. It's great. You've been a big support to the church, and I just want to see more of you, you know? So I wanted to come and see how you're doing. How's everything?
Good. Everything's fine. How are you?
Good. Good. Praise God. God bless your family. How's the kids?
Everybody's good.
Praise the Lord. Praise God. Well, I wanted to encourage you today. We're doing a few things. We're very involved. The church is trying to do some help with feeding the homeless. And also, we're going to a funeral. And I know it's hard. People don't like to go to funerals.
Right.
But as a church, Matthew, we need to go and show love and just be there for them. So I wanted to know if it's okay if you could come with us.
Well, Pastor, I would love to come, but we made plans to go shop for a new car. We're going to shop around and see about getting a new car. So
really? Okay.
I don't think I'm going to make it. Maybe next time.
Wow, Matthew. Okay. It's understandable. I know. You're busy. May the Lord bless the new car that you're going to look for. That God will provide you a beautiful car in Jesus' name.
Amen. Thank
Amen.
You.
But Matthew, I'm not going to give up on you. I want to see you guys more involved.
I know
Zuz
you.
Zuz has been talking about the prayer meeting for the girls.
Yeah.
Apples, you guys are never there. Deep, I'm there. I'm your pastor. I want to encourage you to do more for God. Deto hoje, one day we're going to be before the Bema judgment. And God is waiting for us to bring gold, silver, and precious stones. And whatever we do here on earth is what we're going to be giving to God. So, you know, guys, I want you to bring to God a lot of silver, gold, and precious stones to glorify Jesus. So, as your pastor, I want to encourage you. You could always do more for God. And what about Penel? Don't get tired of doing good. Amen?
Amen.
So, I'm not giving up on you, Matthew. God bless you, man.
God bless you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you for coming.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. I'll talk to you soon.
Why did you come to pasture? Because you're going to look for a car. You could have saved it and do it another day and go with the pasture to the funeral.
It's okay. Make Jalo pastor. That's his job. We have better things to do. Let the pastor, let the other servants go. We don't need that. Baro Pari must go and see that. We don't need to see that. We just need to do what we need to do.
When we get to heaven, there is no jealousy, there is no anger, there is no holy.
Aren't you hungry?
You just know you're in
King heaven. Taco sounds pretty good right
let's
about
go
now.
Back to the evil.
Or maybe
let's
even Portillo's. Why don't you just
what
walk out early
mean?
And get something
the
to
evil
eat?
And the bad
you're starving.
But you're bringing wood,
you don't belong
pain,
here.
And straw to God.
You're not even worthy to call yourself a Christian.
What does that represent? What does that mean?
Why do you waste your time?
To do more
why am
Jesus
I hearing this?
Didn't.
I should be in your word. I should
you
be obeying you.
You bring
Satan,
wood.
Get behind me.
There's a line
you have no authority over me.
You has three, four cards.
You're the best servant here.
I do
you're always on time. You shake everyone's hand. You make people happy.
Get off the line.
This church is full because of you. Why don't you just go and open up your own church? You don't need to follow the pastor anymore. Just do your own thing. I bet you you'd do great without him. This church is the way it is because of you. You're doing such a great job. And you should be proud of yourself.
Not listen to the lies of the enemy. I've called you to serve in this church. I am the one that lives to you. It is me that lives in you, that makes you who you are. You cannot do nothing without me. I've called you to build this church, to be a part of this church. Planted this pastor there, and I put you here to help him, to bring my people to know me, to serve me. Do not listen to the lies. The enemy wants to scatter you away from my church and put pride in your heart and anger in your heart towards the pastor. Listen to my spirit.
Well, look who showed up to church. Can you believe it? Who does she think she is? Being here with you, that's your enemy. You should go knock her out.
Do not hold a grudge against your enemies. Forgive them as I forgave you. Do not hold anger in your heart. For anger is not from me, but love and forgiveness.
What am I supposed to do now? My wife passed away. What's the sense of praying and worshiping all those years? She died, she left my kids alone. There's nobody to watch them, to raise them. What do I do now? What am I supposed to do now? What am I supposed to do now? I don't understand this. Why praise a God that's not there? I don't understand. He's not here, you don't see him. There's no God. It makes no sense. It makes no sense. Pray a God that's not there. Ask for healing. For what? For what? Nothing. Nothing. I didn't see nothing from him. There's no God. No, there's not. At all.
Steve. We halas kino pekacham uz, ay malsala logaya. Jalavki duk, jalavka duka dosa, pod mei saj sas jalavki duk. De aveska rimande edestio ilo, we sas mogu serve. Me ju zivasla, de penel tu, ma man. Steve, da my letu palakacham unja. Me saj lav sama tuka. Me sai lá sama kata ki glati. Sai barion ti janen man. Ani mugo presence. Ani kangari. Steve. Nazu gyakyo ilo kari mande. Deityo trayo mande. Na letu pala kacha lumia. Ka kacha lumia kocha veltu. Kado duk ka sutu. Sai ni karatu. Ano tano nasu. Ba deityo trayo mande.
Take another shot. What are you waiting for? Drink it up. Because that's what gives you peace. You're by yourself in this world. You have no one and nothing anymore. What kind of God lets people go through this? What kind of God takes away a young woman from her husband to leave him alone? What kind of God would let people suffer? There is no God. This is your God. Drink it up. Come on, you can handle it. That's right. You're a young man. You didn't deserve this. You deserve to live a happy life. But there you are, all alone. What kind of God would take your family? leave you like this. She didn't deserve to die, this young. God isn't real.
I rebuke you to be gone. Steve, not Ashun Listy. These are lies to destroy you. These are lies to corrupt you. Do not listen to these lies. That drink is not your peace. Listen to my voice. Listen to my word. Because I can give you peace. The world will not give you peace. The world will not give you healing. This will lead you more on a road to destruction.
Hey, Steve. How are you?
I'm gonna be doctor. I'm in the hospital bed. You tell me. What is it, doctor? Tell me. Explain it to me, please.
Steve, there's no real easy way for me to say this.
Say what? Say what's the easy? What are you talking about, doctor?
We just got the results back, Steve. And at this point, even with treatment, you're looking at a month at the most.
What are you saying? You tell me I only got a month to live? There's gotta be something. There's gotta be pills. There's gotta be anything to help.
I'm sorry, Steve, but at this point, it would take a miracle.
A miracle? A miracle? Where was my wife's miracle? Are you one of those people? Are you a Christian? I don't believe in miracles. Get out of my room. Leave me alone. Leave me alone. Please. I went through enough. I don't understand. I'm about to live. Why? Why? I don't understand this. I don't understand. Why?
Hey, Steve. How are you, buddy?
Buddy, I'll be like...
Hey, come on, Steve.
You wrong your people. You wrong your entourage.
Steve,
so my good man.
We came... We came from the church. Give us just an opportunity. Let's swim, please. Relax. I know you're going through a lot, brother.
Yes.
Listen.
Yes.
Okay, we're not here for anything else.
Yes.
We just come to see you. We came just to visit you. We don't want nothing from you. But I want you to know that God does want something from you.
God.
He wants your heart, Steve.
You're bringing God to me.
It's not that I'm bringing God to you, Steve. Is that I'm trying to bring you to God. And this is why we're here. We're here because we care for you.
Let us pray with you, Steve.
Ever since your wife, Dick.
Your
wife used to come to church.
Why did church get her? Why did the praise get her? Nothing. What was her miracle?
Our ways is not God's ways. I cannot explain.
I don't believe.
I don't have all the answers.
There was no miracles. Please.
But God does have the answers.
Could you come here? I'm already sick enough.
Steve,
I don't know if you
your
heard.
Your wife loved Jesus.
Jesus.
Your wife is with God. And what about Penel? Absent from the body. Present with the Lord.
I'm sorry.
Steve.
I'm sorry. I don't believe.
Steve.
There was no miracles.
She
there
loved
was nothing.
Jesus. The miracle.
How do you love something when it's not there?
But the miracle is that she was saved.
There is no such thing as miracles.
She's in heaven.
Where's my miracle?
Her name is in the Lamb's Book of Life.
Jesus is another angel? Doesn't he have enough? Huh?
Steve, I'm not saying that.
You want to tell me Jesus needed her? Is that what you want to tell me right now?
What I'm trying to tell you, Steve, is for you to accept Jesus in your heart.
I don't accept. Please. Don't mind us about the. Why don't you just leave and leave me alone? I didn't call you here.
Steve. Give God opportunity.
I didn't bring you here.
A miracle in your life.
There is no such thing as miracles. I'm talking to the pastor.
But God could do a miracle.
There is no miracles. I don't believe. Where was my wife's miracles? She prayed, she worshiped, she gave her tithes. Nothing, nothing. And you want me to believe? You want me to pray? You want to ask my forgiveness now? No, it's not gonna happen.
Steve, we just want to pray with you. It's simple words.
Steve. I said no!
But Steve, we're...
Let them go Monday. Why don't you just leave now? Please leave!
Hey, Steve. The Lord be with you.
Can we pray with you
no.
before we go?
No! Go pray for some of the Christian that needs it. I don't want your prayer.
Steve, you're rejecting Jesus, Steve. You're rejecting
you
Jesus.
You can't reject nobody if you don't believe him. Please. Let them come on day.
All right, Steve. We love you, Steve.
Yeah. Tell something that cares. Check again, please! Check! No, I'm not going, no!
Steve, there's no other choice. Angels,
You're guilty, Steve.
No.
You're guilty for rejecting me as
your Lord. I don't want to go there. No, stop it, please. No.
Oh, Steve. I know I'm not the only one who regrets the things they've done. I bet you regret not accepting Jesus when you had the chance. You see, I use tragedies, and I poke at them, and poke at them. I keep your mind on the bad things you've been through, so that you can harden your heart towards God. Death in the families, unexplained phenomena, accidents. You have a choice to let them go and give them to Jesus so that Jesus can take your pain away. Or you can dwell on them all your life and never let go. And I'll use them against you so that you can harden your heart towards God. Steve, you had a choice to accept Jesus the same way your wife did, but you chose to reject him because of your pain, because of your hurt, and because of your anger. And now you make me so happy to say that you get to burn in the lake of fire for eternity. Good riddance. See you in hell.
People, don't wait to get to this spot to ask Jesus for forgiveness. Don't waste your time in the bars, drinking your life away, staying in the casinos. The world ain't gonna give you nothing. Jesus is holding on, he's reaching out to you. Hold on to him, follow him. He wants to love you. He wants to hold on to you.
Take him into the outer bar.
No, I'm not going! No!
Motiva de Samariduk is very great, and sometimes Samariduk becomes anger. In our anger, we tend to forget sometimes why you're even angry. Motiva de you're angry and you're having problems and you forgot why you're angry. Today, God wants to give you peace. Jesus said, "Peace I give you." Receive his peace, but apart from his peace, receive Jesus in your heart. Then is Barimos. Amen.
Thank you, my Lord!
over you for you endure to the end. Blessed is he who endures to the end, for he will receive a crown of life. He will receive his real estate in heaven. Now, you will be in my presence for eternity.
Thank you, Lord.
You will be in my presence with my Father. You will be in my presence because you overcame this world. You did not love your life so much to death. You denied yourself. And you follow me. He led them in Balakongo. He led them in Balakandi. Even when things were hard, he condemned them in Kalimandi. Even when things were tough, like she had a dead, you held on. My son Matthew, come forward. Use the right to be on judgment. This is a celebration. To where each one will receive the rewards of Ohio for the things done on earth. Matthew, Mohoshav, God, my son, Stupidori, you receive my salvation. You receive my word. But Pandemon is the Mohoshav. Down the day of judgment, every person's work will be revealed by gold, silver, and precious stones, and hay and stubble. Matthew, my son, you have real estate on the Bible. Your name is written in the last book of life. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So Matthew, I gave you many opportunities. I gave you many opportunities to go to the hurt and to the poor, but you were lazy. You didn't do what I called you to do. I had so much in store for you, but I will put this in the fire, and whatever survives, you will receive your reward. But you have eternal life from the Bible. Wood and stumbled. It was burnt up. It did not survive. But hide, come into my kingdom. Your name is written. Hallelujah.
I have nothing to offer to the Lord Jesus because of my disobedience. But the Lord still accepted me. He gave me a white robe and eternal life. Store your treasures in heaven. That one day when you put before the Lord, you have treasures in heaven.
Hallelujah.
Well. The rapture of the church took place. I've got a question for you. Did you make it? Because if you didn't accept Jesus, you'll be left behind with me.
Satan!
Yes, Jesus.
You bruised my heel 2,000 years ago, and I crushed your head.
Oh, Jesus.
You have no authority over my church and my people.
No. Please.
So you go into the lake of fire.
Every knee will bow, and every tongue will confess that Jesus Christ is Lord forever.
To me, all this world,
I said in my word, do not store up for yourselves treasures on earth, but store up for yourselves treasures in heaven. Where moth and rust do not destroy, where thieves don't come in and steal. But where your heart is, there your treasure is. I have many great things in store for you in my kingdom. What you do on earth will be shown on the day of judgment. And great is your reward in heaven. Nico, because of your dedication, and you receive me as Lord and Savior.
Thank you, Pastor. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Come on.
God bless you, everybody. It's amazing what God is doing right now. People are coming to the altar. People are coming to receive Jesus. There's over 80 people that are coming to filling up the altar to accept Jesus for the first time. Where are you? What are you doing? If you never accepted Jesus as Lord and Savior, I plead with you, receive Jesus right now. Join these people coming to the altar. Join them together as we pray and we accept Jesus to come into our hearts to be our Lord and Savior. Or maybe you accepted Jesus. Maybe you backslided from the Lord. Maybe it's been years since you've been in church or read the Bible or prayed. It's time to come back to your dad. It's time to come back to his feet. God is waiting for you. God has been waiting for you. Come and let's give the prayer of rededication. I want to give you an opportunity to accept the Lord and to come back to Jesus again. So join us as I lead the church in prayer.
Jesus, today I accept you as my Lord and Savior. Plead that you died and resurrected on the third day. You are coming soon, and I am waiting. Today, come in my heart, be my God, and be my Savior. We pray in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.